Welcome to this special training camp edition as we kick off training camp edition of Bucs Weekly. Of course, I am your host, Jeff Barnes, and here we are. The 2024 season is very, very close. Training camps are underway around the league. The Bucs are on the field and working already. And we've got some news, and we're going to talk about the whole offseason as we're trying to get one in, just couldn't get it into you. So we're going to cram all of that into this week as we're kicking off training camp. We'll talk about some of the current events. We'll talk about everything the offseason has set up this team for training camp. But first things first, hope you got to enjoy your offseason. Hope you got to enjoy the draft. Enjoy the process. If you haven't watched Draft Central with myself and Bill Carroll, make sure you watch it next draft season so you make sure you're up on all the Bucs. On all the draft picks, so when the Bucs are picking, you know exactly who's on the board. We do a great job all 3 days live here at Team BS Media, especially on Draft Central. Leading up to that, we have a lot of prospects come through. We break down prospects all the way from the top of the board to the bottom. So with that being said, we're going to get into this offseason and what the Bucs have done so far. And it's been a very successful offseason. Yeah, people were worried about it. I don't know. We talked about it when I last saw you guys at the end of the playoffs, that heartbreaking loss in Detroit. But it comes back, to the point where you got to improve your team. You got to make some changes. We know Shaq Barrett's gone. You know, there have been changes, in certain places on the offensive line. There are changes. But they've made some great strides. And one of the things you do is you go out in a free agency, right? So you go out in a free agency and you land some people in free agency that basically are going to help your team. Ben Bredesen, excellent depth on the offensive line. Defensive lineman Ernest Brown, depth play as well. Randy Gregory was meant to come in and contribute to this pass rush. We're going to talk about him in a minute. Bryce Hall gives you another option at corner. Big pickup there. Lorenz Metz, another offensive line depth guy. It comes in and competes. Same thing with Sue Opetta. There's going to be a lot of competition on this offensive line. They want to vastly improve it. They want to improve the running game. They want to protect Baker Mayfield a little bit more. So they do a lot. But here are some of the things that we saw, all right? Some major changes, and we're going to talk about it here. Okay? So Tavaire Thomas, cornerback, another cornerback depth player, right? Cody Thompson, a young wide receiver. I've scouted a few years ago coming out in the draft. Liked him a lot. Guy that just hasn't fully made an impact on a 53 roster, but he's been around the league, right? He's a guy that you want to see make some bigger plays and get a lot more production out of so he can contribute a lot more. And you want to see him get that payday, right? You want to see him earn his pay. So I think he's going to come in here. He's going to compete for depth. Special teams is definitely something he's used to. But there were certain names of this offseason we got to go back to, right? So, and that starts with, of course, you had to get QB1 secured. That was the big thing. Are they going to be able to get Evans and Mayfield? Well, we saw they got Evans locked in. They turn around, Baker Mayfield resigns, okay? So you got your wide receiver one, Godwin's taken care of, so your receivers are there, your quarterback is back. You're feeling good about yourselves, right? Well, you have one more guy, Antoine Winfield. You're able to tag him. That sets up a big deal, right? Then he goes and gets his deal later this offseason. So everybody that were trying to lock down, they did, and they did with great with the big deals. So that's a big win for Chris Light, the GM here in Tampa Bay. Todd Bowles is happy with that. He's gotten the continuity with the team that he wants. Then you add pieces to go along with what you got, right? You didn't let some guys go, but you got to get better, right? And one of the first things they did was they went out there, they went at a pass rush. Okay, we'll get on that in a minute. But one of the also things is, hey, you have a safety that you just rewarded. You had a really good one before. They brought him back. Jordan Whitehead comes back to the fold here in Tampa. So that's a big pickup, right? Safety depth. You got a young safety we're going to talk about in a little while. These are all things that you do to build this roster. The one thing you want to do is you want to marry free agency in the draft, right? And that's exactly what Chris Light did. He came out there, he resigned his guys, he set up his roster, he saw he had holes. I'm going to fill it in in free agency, and I'm going to fill them in the draft, and I'm going to make sure all my holes are filled, even if it's with temporary guys. So you look at Jordan Whitehead, he's a guy, you're filling a hole. Now, he could be a long-term or a temporary guy. That's up to them. How much they want to pay, how much the young guys pan out. If the young guys are panning out, you ain't got to pay them, right? You can move on. So there's so many things to do, but he plugs many main hole that you had. There's another hole. I kept talking about the production at receiver, inconsistent from wide receiver 3 to 5. Well, you bring in a guy named Sterling Shepard, who's a big-time producer with the Giants, kind of fell out with the staff there. Not so much because of attitude or production, just because they wanted to get better. He's a slot, really, and we could play flanker, but he's really more of a slot. So he's a guy that's going to give Godwin time in a slot to move around. He can play outside, he can play inside. Those guys are going to be interchangeable. So it's going to do a lot of things with this Bucs offense, and he's going to create some openings and work off of other guys, things he didn't have in New York. So he gives you a lot of chances. A lot of different options. Plus, if you can keep him from fighting through injuries, right, he's going to be a very productive player. So you've seen upgrades on this offense. This was supposed to be an upgrade. Randy Gregory coming here to help out your pass rush for an aging Shaq Barrett moving on, right? Tryon Shawinka has had up and down mixed results. So here's a guy who had some really productive years in Dallas when he was active. Basically comes here to come in and try and upgrade this pass rush. And already here we are to open training camp, and he is nowhere to be found. He was in some several unexcused absences in mini camps and OTAs. And here he is there at training camp, and there's no Randy Gregory. So I wanted to really end off with this portion of free agency with Randy Gregory, because let's dig into the player. Okay, Randy Gregory is a player. I liked Randy Gregory coming out of Wisconsin, talent-wise. There was a lot of things to worry about with Randy Gregory when it comes to the football side. That was always a concern, all right, because there were certain things about him, right? Personality. He has a personality that's not for everyone. Okay. He had the issues with weed. We know about that. It was mostly because he was self-medicating with depression and anxiety. And he was gotten help for that during his suspensions in Dallas. Came back, had some very productive years at the end of his Cowboys career. Goes to Denver, gets a big payday, never lives up to it. So they move him on. They move him to San Francisco. He has some flashes here and there, just doesn't get it done. They go to the Super Bowl even with a more roster. They fall, of course, to Kansas City for the second time. And San Francisco says, thanks for no thanks. Okay, so he's looking on the market, and he lands in Tampa Bay. And already, we haven't even gotten a training camp, and he's already started to rub people the wrong way. Now we're in training camp, and forget rubbing people the wrong way. He's basically working himself out of town. There is something wrong with this. And I'm going to say, I'm saying this period. I'm not saying just the player. Okay. I don't know if he came into this situation, felt that he wasn't going to get along with Todd Bowles, and basically was going to basically ask the team to show him the door without asking him to show the door. Sometimes players do that. They check out, they do all this stuff so you can cut them. And they can find a home where they feel comfortable. Maybe it's something different. It could be a relapse. He could be having a relapse of some of his issues from the past. We don't know that. This is all speculation, right? But the main thing is he's not here. And that's a problem, because you were banking on him coming and being a part of this rotation. It hasn't happened. And Bucs fans, they're frustrated right now, because you just got the training camp and you're already talking about a potential bust in a free agent signing, one that they were counting on. Randy Gregory is a enigmatic player, to say the least. I've watched him, like I said, in the draft. He fell late in the second to Dallas for a reason. Okay. The character concerns, they were all validated by the time he got to Dallas. We saw it all play out. The stupid penalties were different, various reasons, whether it was personal fouls, whether it was jumping off sides, whether it was, you know, face masking guys. There were just stupid penalties after stupid penalties with Randy Gregory. Suspension. It's up the wazoo. Okay. And they were all for weed. We know that. We know why. Okay. But he cleaned himself up. He gave himself the second chance, and he took it. Or a third, if you want to count all the suspensions. Third and fourth. But he took advantage of his chances to fix his career. And to see him within months of signing, possibly tossing it out. I mean, Todd Bowles is frustrated. We see that. We understand that. I understand it as a coach. Unfortunately, I'm not the coach of the Bucs, so it's not something I control. I just report on it. So Todd Bowles, that's all. That's all on Todd Bowles. He's got to figure out what they want to do. Him and Chris Leiter got to come together and say, are we going to release this guy? We're going to keep working with him. For all we know is what we know is what we know. We're not getting the greatest information. You're not going to. If it's something more in depth that they know about, they're going to tell us what they need to tell us. And right now, what they're telling us is he's not here. We're working. He's not here. He's being fined. This is what happens when you don't show up for training camp and mandatory activities. You get fined per day. So he's being fined. The fines are accumulating. This is something that we really, really have to look at when you're Bucs fans and say, wow, this is the risk of free agency. This is why teams, when they go into the draft, are willing to wheel and deal to get guys. They're willing to load up on draft picks and load up on a bunch of guys. Because you're going to have some guys who don't pan out in the draft too, but you're not paying them a lot of money. Free agents come with a lot of money. Veterans, especially the guys that have made a good amount of money, they're not cheap. They may not have top five salaries, but you're paying a Randy Gregory a good, cool couple of million dollars, you know, to be exact. I mean, I could pull up his contract, and honestly, his deal is not, technically, it's not cheap, you know, and 5 years he signed with Denver. Okay, so we're going to look up the Bucs contract. Yeah, one-year deal. Okay. So let's try to find the exact financials on his deal with the Bucs. It's a one-year deal, so it's not, you know, they're not breaking the bank on him. However, this doesn't come cheap, right? So yeah, we're going to really dig into this here. I want to make sure I'm giving you guys accurate information. You know, going through a couple of, I don't see it, but I know exactly where to find it though. Okay, so here we are. So there's always sites when you start looking at caps, they always tell you the details. So right now, he's on a one-year deal with a base salary of $1.37 million. Okay, $1.37 million. That's rounded up, by the way. Okay, it's really $1.365, but we round up to $1.37. Okay, so he's getting close to $1.5 million in base salary. Okay, he has a roster bonus of $1.1 million. Okay, and so he has overall a cap hit for this year, okay, for 2024. He is due basically, when you look at it, $3 million. So he signed a 1 year, $3 million deal for the most part. Contract value is $3 million, APY. Okay, so there you have it. $1.3 million. They're paying him $3 million basically for this year. And guess what? You didn't get anything for your $3 million so far. All right, so maybe this situation does get resolved, whatever's going on. Maybe he becomes a little more communicative with the organization and lets them know what is the deal, why he's not there. Or maybe they have told him and they just don't feel like telling us. We don't know. But I tell you this much, he's not in training camp. $3 million, I tell you what, I can do a lot with $3 million. So that tells you it's not exactly cheap when you spend it on veterans. Very few rookies get $3 million for 1 year. Usually it's a first-round pick. Okay, so this is what I'm talking about by free agency versus the draft. This is why teams will spend in free agency, but then they look to go cheap, and then they fill everything else in the draft. They fill in the holes, the bigger holes, if they can, in free agency. Okay, so getting off the free agency train. Let's take a quick break. We'll come back. We'll talk about this draft class. Oh, yes, we're going to talk about the draft, my specialty, when we come back here on Bucs Weekly.
Enjoy 40% off site-wide. Vitable takes the guesswork out of feeling good. Get your own personalized daily vitamin pack safely delivered to your doorstep every month. Take their online quiz to find out which vitamins and minerals can support your personal needs based on your own diet and lifestyle. Hashtag only what you need, nothing that you don't. All vitamins are manufactured in Australia at the highest quality standard. Ingredients come in the best form for their absorption by your body. Enjoy 40% off site-wide using code NBS40 at checkout.
We're back here with, once again, the early beginning training camp preview, as I like to call it, edition of Bucs Weekly. We're back for 2024. You'll be seeing me a lot more going forward. Once again, this fall, you'll be seeing me on The Last Word, which is moving to Saturday nights. We'll be literally the last word on Saturday night now. Now that you don't have a ton of Pac-12 after dark, Pac-12, you know, is no more. So not too many of those games late at night, but you will see us, myself, Greg Rector, Brock Vieira. And sometimes you're going to have some standing hosts as I'll be on the road scouting. So, you know, when I can't get back to the studio in time, there'll be somebody in my seat holding it down. But The Last Word will be back. Also, Moving the Chains will be back Sunday mornings at the NFL preview show, weekly preview show, hosted by Ashmir Prasad. So that will be back. You'll have me as a panelist on there as well. Sometimes a host when Ashmir's not around. So you'll be seeing a lot of me still. Bucs Weekly will be, once again, we're taped. We're not live on this show. So you will be seeing me every week during the fall with Bucs Weekly. You'll see, and I'm also going to be doing some training camp shows. So I still have some traveling to do before the season. So there'll be a couple more episodes before we get to the regular season. Okay, so we have some season preview shows coming up as well in August, the 6th, the 8th. 20th and the 22nd. So stay tuned for more information on those. Yes, a lot of content, NFL and college wise, coming to you here from Team NBS Media. Of course, moving forward now, okay, we talked about the free agency side of the offseason for the Bucs. Let's talk about the draft. My love fest with this draft process in the NFL. And it's because it means so much. Okay, you have a 53-man roster, you have a hard salary cap. You have to be able to pay for people and fill holes in free agency and fill it in the draft. And you got to hit on this young man. You got to bring in talent and find a way to use it. And teams are doing that, right? So let's talk about the draft. Let's hear from me.
Every year, the Bucs do everything they can in the offseason to improve the season, starting in free agency by adding some key players. They added a Randy Gregory to the team, but also, most importantly, they will keep guys like Baker Mayfield, Mike Evans, and of course, Antoine Winfield Jr. But you have to go a little bit further, and that's where this comes into play. We're talking about the NFL draft. So the Bucs went out there. They made some key picks through their, with their seven picks in the draft. They added some key players. Graham Barton definitely comes in to shore up the offensive line, a guy that can play guard and tackle. Chris Braswell will replace Shaq Barrett in that pass rush rotation. Also, he added in Tyke Smith, safety from Georgia, who adds some key safety depth, possibly a future starter. Jalen McMillan, wide receiver out of Washington, and Devin Culp, tight end out of Washington, come in to add quality depth to this receiving core and tight end room. And, of course, Bucky Irving, the speedster out of Oregon, comes into the backfield to make some explosive plays. They need some more pop beside Rashawn White. Bucky Irving can provide that for you. And, of course, Elijah Klein adds depth to the interior of this offensive line, and a guy who could potentially, with a lot of improvement and some refining, could be a spot starter for you. So they added some key players in this offseason, and that's what you want to see from your draft. When you're putting this draft board together, you want to be able to go through all seven picks, plus an undrafted free agency, and add some guys to your training camp roster that could possibly impact your 53.
So we're talking about this draft class. Well, Graham Barton in the first was a great pick. And you look at how the Bucs did it. They knew Dallas was moving around. They were thinking about moving up. Dallas moves back behind them, believe it or not. Did the Bucs say, well, you know what? We got the guy we want. Cody Barton's right there. Let's go get him. And he's a great pick because what can Cody Barton do? He can be your right tackle. He can be your right guard. He can be a left guard. He is a position flexible player that can play anywhere on the offensive line. If you're showing up right tackle with Cody Barton, he's your man. If you want to put him inside, guess what? He's good enough to do that as well. So he's one of those guys that you want to see come into camp and have a great camp, because then they're going to find a way to get him involved early, often, and it helps upgrade this offensive line. Then you talk about pass rush, okay? Now, Dallas Turner was the top pass rusher at Alabama. Number two was this young man right here, Chris Braswell. So Braswell comes in, and he gives you that rotational player. He could be the guy that pushes Tryon Shawinka out. He could be the guy that you say, you know what, screw it, Randy Gregory, you're not here. This young man is playing well. Take your 1-point-something mil. We'll keep the rest. And we'll go bet on a merry way. You can go find another team that you actually want to show up for. Tyke Smith is interesting. Safety player, smart, intelligent, very athletic, still kind of raw intent in certain techniques when it comes to defensive back play, but overall, very good ball player. Things are going to learn a lot in this secondary and learn a lot from a former DB, Ty Bowles. So there's a lot there. Jalen McMillan, right? You saw Sterling Shepard. We talked about the wide receiver room. Here's a young guy who's going to surprise people. The speed is undoubtedly there. But here's a guy that's going to sneak up on people. Don't be surprised if he has a very productive training camp and finds ways on the football field. Bucky Irving in the fourth. Love Bucky Irving. One of my favorite backs in this class. The one knock on him is size. He's not very big, but he is explosive. And we didn't see a ton of explosive plays other than Rashad White last year. They would love to get a lot more explosive in a running game. So he's definitely going to help with that. Okay. You talk about sixth round, Elijah Klein. This is value, right? We talk about depth. We saw all of the guys they brought in free agency to play offensive line. Here's a young one that can come in and compete with those guys. And he could possibly beat out some of those guys. And if he does that, here's a guy that's going to be in this depth for a while and can improve the interior offensive line. Okay, so Devin Culp, another athletic tight end coming in from Washington, and a tight end room that needs some more vertical threats, okay? Culp can do that, not only through with his blocking, but a very good receiver catching the football as a tight end. So he's a guy that's going to be more of a move tight end than in line wide. He's going to move around a formation, create some matchups. K-Dot is going to be the main guy. Definitely a guy that you look at. Parham's another one. You got an excellent three tight ends with Culp here. So definitely a value pick in seventh. All right. So this is what you want out of your draft class. So you marry that free agent class, you know, and I count the guys that you keep as part of your free agency, right? Because they're technically free agents. All right. So by keeping Evans, by keeping Mayfield, by keeping Winfield, by re-upping Godwin, then turn around, signing Shepard and these guys, okay? Then drafting this class, you have had a very productive offseason. Very productive if you're the Bucs. This is the kind of offseason that you look forward to. This training camp should be fun. You should be watching position battle after position battle on this roster with excitement. To Bucs fans, you're watching training camp. Enjoy it. We've got another week before we start to literally get into preseason football. So we start to get some preseason games, and you're going to see a lot of these depth guys in action. Ignore the scores. The one part about it is they're learning to play together. Most of these guys aren't going to be playing together during the season. Take the scores with a grain of salt. Watch the games. Watch the players. Look at the talent. If you're looking at talent in the back end of your team, you know you got a darn good team, okay? So that's what you're looking at right now. If you're watching this team going, the guys are pretty good. They're not a team yet, but they're pretty good. I can see the talent. Feel good about it, Bucs fans. I feel real good about it. So I'm not going to be able to bring you a Bucs weekly next week. I will be traveling. But the week after, we should have our first preseason game in the books. So, or getting ready for our first preseason game. So either way, in 2 weeks, I'll be back with Bucs Weekly. And hopefully have some great news to go along with it to share with you. But right now, I just want to say thanks for watching. We are back. 2024 football is that much closer. And get ready, Bucs fans. It's going to be a heck of a ride, all right? So for Jeff Barnes here and Team MBS Media, thanks for watching Bucs Weekly. We will be back with more. And, of course, the man, the myth, the legend himself, Bucified Bert, is going to take us out.
Go Bucs, baby.